What's up, everyone? Carlos here. So the reveal stream of Destiny 2 just wrapped up today, so let's go over everything we saw in the footage. So like it's been mentioned before, everyone is going to start fresh. You're not going to transfer any weapons, any gear, any armor, nothing at all. So they also mentioned something about solo players having a special activity. Now, PvP is being changed to 4 versus 4 from 6 versus 6, and it's going to have smaller maps. Now, trials, nightfall, and raids are also available to all players now. So the intro starts off with a cabal called the Red Legion attacking the tower. We see cabal with incinerator weapons, and in typical fashion, their fuel tanks can be ignited with gunfire to explode. Now, the warlock has a new healing ability called Healing Rift, and I've wanted a healing class for so long, and finally we got it. So it looks like the warlock has an area of white light beneath them, and that heals you as long as you're inside that area. Later on, they showed an arc rocket launcher being shown to fire multiple tracking rockets in a single shot, which seemed pretty cool. Now, another new weapon we saw are miniguns, which are a new type of heavy weapon. Now, although the game looks like it's reusing character models and animations, I did notice there are more particle effects during gun battles or explosions. Now, the raiding environment looks really nice as well, and also they added a grenade launcher into the game. Now, at the end of that trailer, we got to see Gaal, who's probably the end boss of the story mode or probably in the raid somewhere. So during this attack, all the guardians lose their light, and with that, they lose their powers. So it's a fresh start to regain everything you lost. Now, there's also a look at the menu screen. So the kinetic weapon is now your primary, energy weapons are your special, and power weapons are now the heavy weapons. Now you can see there's a slot at the bottom for something called a weapon mod. Perhaps these are things you can add to the weapon that change how they work. Perhaps maybe adding cluster bombs to your favorite rocket launcher, or maybe adding a larger magazine to your machine gun. I like what this idea can possibly do because it can give us more freedom with our weapons. So now let's look at the new super moves. The warlock used a solar sword with a new vertical smash attack, and was able to throw fiery projectiles. The sentinel can summon a shield that can be used for defense and melee charges. Also, it can be thrown as a projectile that bounces off enemies. The hunter class will summon an arc staff. The hunter will be very agile during this stage as it attacks with massive arc damage in melee combat. Now, we also got to see the dubious volley rocket launcher that was left out of Destiny 1 and now makes an appearance in Destiny 2. The Titan was also able to have an ability that places a temporary shield but is somewhat small. There was also a bubble that was similar to what was seen in the Halo series. So the Red War campaign is going to send you across the solar system for many missions. Strikes are coming back. The first one is called Inverted Spire. This boss is supposed to have three stages during that battle. And obviously, Crucible is coming back. Now they have a new game mode called Countdown. It looks like it's a game mode where you fight to control an area just for points. Now a new feature in the game is being able to launch any activity without going to orbit. They also mentioned something called Lost Sectors. Supposedly, there will be a hidden dungeon and bosses that will guard a cache of loot. You beat the boss, you get the loot. Simple as that. You can now go directly to any planet, which makes it quicker and easier to reach your destination. Now the new worlds look really nice. They're supposed to be a lot bigger, which gives you more areas to explore. They also mentioned that clans will now be included inside Destiny 2. You'll be able to form a roster and make your own banner. They also added clan rewards, so that means when you play, you help get rewards for yourself just by playing, and you also help your team and your clan getting rewards. Now, guided games is a new feature to pick a clan you want to be paired up with for a session of doing a raid, trials, or even a strike. Now, you get to see which clans are hosting, and you can see what type of players they are looking for. Think of it as an in-game version of a forum where you can look up a group to play with. You can read their details and see their clan information. And if that's a group you want to play with, you can join their session. This is going to make finding groups for raids, trials, and nightfalls a lot more easier. Now, the dog creatures from the reveal trailer a while ago are now seen as new enemies in the game. And the last thing was some news for the PC community for Destiny 2. It's going to be part of the Battle.net, which is what Blizzard uses for their online games. Now, I also caught a glimpse of the Titan still having the arc-based Titan Smash super move. Now, I just wanted to put that out there for some Titan players that are wondering if you still had that super move available. So that's it for my breakdown of what we saw in Destiny 2's livestream for the reveal. Now, there might be some things I missed, so feel free to add them in the comments section. But for what I saw, I'm excited to play the game and try out all the new stuff. I think my favorite thing so far is having the sword as a super and the extra guardian ability. Although I must say, the graphics don't seem that different from the first game, but the worlds do look a little bit more well-designed and more detailed, and the particle effects are more noticeable now. Now, I'm also curious as to what the hardware specs are for this game on PC. Now, the game looks decent and interesting, and at the same time, I can't wait to dive in and start getting all the new loot. Now, they did mention that they have a lot of new exotic items in this game, but I'm also wondering if we will see any classic exotic items return in Destiny 2. I know I'm going to miss my Gjallarhorn and also my Thorn, which are my two most used exotic weapons in Destiny 1. Heck, I even used Thorn in raids just because I liked the poison effect. I thought it was really fun. So if you saw the reveal of Destiny 2, what was your favorite thing that they mentioned? Put it down in the comment section. And what platform will you get Destiny 2 on? I'm going to get it on Xbox One. So thanks for watching. My name is Astaglow, and I'll see you in the next video.